On today's Halloween edition of Nerd of the Rings, we are talking about one of the spookiest aspects of Middle-earth, the Dead Men of Dunharrow, the Oathbreakers. Also known as the Forgotten Men, they were once known as the Men of the Mountains. They were descended from pre-Numenorean peoples related to the Dunlendings. Now, pre-Numenorean is a term for men who originated in Middle-earth but were not descended from Numenor, though these men did share a common ancestry via the Edain. These men of the White Mountains flourished during the Second Age. Later, during the Dark Years, when the races of Middle-earth suffered under Sauron's domination, these men actually worshipped him. This devotion would come to an end, however, after the foundation of Gondor. In 3319 of the Second Age, the island of Numenor is destroyed. Among its survivors, that is, the Numenoreans who remained faithful, are Isildur, his father Elendil, and brother Anarion. Isildur and his brother Anarion established the realm of Gondor in 3320. One of the few things to be brought to Middle-earth out of the ruin of Numenor was a great black spherical stone. Isildur brings the stone, which measures roughly 6 feet in diameter, and sets it upon the hill of Erech, in the northern area of Lamedon, south of the White Mountains in Gondor. There, the local hill tribes swear an oath of loyalty. It is here that the King of the Men of the Mountains swears allegiance to Isildur and the Dunedain, turning from their allegiance to Sauron. However, when the time comes for the formation of the Last Alliance, they break their oath. And rather than assisting in the overthrow of their former master, they hide in the mountains. Isildur curses them to remain without rest until they fulfill the oath which they swore to him, saying, "Thou shalt be the last king. And if the West prove mightier than thy black master, this curse I lay upon thee and thy folk. To rest never until your oath is fulfilled. For this war will last through years uncounted, and you shall be summoned once again ere the end." Bound by this curse, the men do not die and go to the afterlife that awaits men. Rather, they linger as wraiths in Middle-earth, haunting the caverns beneath the Dwemerberg. Now you may wonder how it is that a mortal such as Isildur could curse these men so powerfully. However, it's not merely the curse that contains power, but also the original oath they swore. In Tolkien's world, oaths have power, as we see in instances like the oath sworn by Cirion and Eorl, and the dreadful oath of Feanor and his sons. In the years to come, the people who dwell in the valley won't go near the stone, as it becomes a mysterious and eerie place. Many of these valley folk come to believe that the stone had fallen from the sky and was haunted by restless spirits. By the end of the Third Age, the area is completely abandoned. This valley comes to be known as the Paths of the Dead. We know of at least one instance where the perilousness of this path was shown. In 2569, as the Great Hall of Meduseld is completed in Edoras, Prince Baldur of Rohan vows to traverse the Paths of the Dead. He would never return, and his father, King Brego, would die of grief a year later. Now, roughly 600 years earlier, during the reign of King Arvedui of Arthedain, a seer named Malbeth foretold of a day when Arvedui's descendant would come to the Paths of the Dead over 1,000 years later. The prophecy reads, "Over the land there lies a long shadow, westward reaching wings of darkness. The tower trembles to the tomb of kings. Doom approaches. The dead awaken, for the hour has come for the Oathbreakers. At the Stone of Erech they shall stand again, and hear there a horn in the hills ringing. Whose shall the horn be? Who shall call them from the grey twilight, the forgotten people? The heir of him to whom the oath they swore. From the north he shall come. Need shall drive him. He shall pass the door to the Paths of the Dead." As we go forward to the time of the War of the Ring, it is these words that the sons of Elrond, at their father's request, bring to Aragorn, reminding him of the prophecy and encouraging him to take the Paths of the Dead. Aragorn, Gimli, Legolas, and the Grey Company, a group of 30 northern Dunedain, and Elrond's sons Eladan and Elrohir arrive at Dunharrow on March 7th. The following morning, they travel through the Dimmelt to the Paths of the Dead. At midnight, Aragorn reaches the Stone of Erech and calls on the dead to fulfill their oath. To that stone the company came and halted in the dead of night. Then Elrohir gave to Aragorn a silver horn, and he blew upon it. And it seemed to those that stood near that they heard a sound of answering horns, as if it was an echo in deep caves far away. No other sound they heard, and yet they were aware of a great host gathered all about the hill on which they stood, and a chill wind like the breath of ghosts came down from the mountains. But Aragorn dismounted, and standing by the stone, he cried in a great voice,
"Oathbreakers, why have ye come?"
And a voice was heard out of the night that answered him, as if from far away,
"To fulfill our oath and have peace."
Then Aragorn said,
"The hour has come at last. Now I go to Pelargir, upon Anduin, and ye shall come after me. And when all this land is clean of the servants of Sauron, I will hold the oath fulfilled, and ye shall have peace and depart forever. For I am Elessar, Isildur's heir of Gondor."
And with that he bade Halbrand unfurl the great standard which he had brought, and behold, it was black, and if there was any device upon it, it was hidden in the darkness. Then there was silence. The company camped beside the stone, but they slept little, because of the dread of the shadows that hedged them round. The next day they leave Erech, traveling through the Gondorian lands south of the White Mountains. On March 13th, they arrive at Pelargir, finding it overrun by corsairs with 50 great ships and many more smaller vessels, ready to sail to Harland, the port of Minas Tirith. The Haradrim laugh when they see Aragorn and his small company of 30-plus mortals. At this moment, Aragorn cries in a great voice,
"Now come! By the Black Stone, I call you!"
Suddenly, the shadow host comes up like a gray tide, sweeping all away before it. Gimli later describes it, saying,
"Pale swords were drawn, but I know not whether their blades would still bite, for the dead no longer needed any weapon but fear."
The dead pass over the water to the ships. Their enemies are filled with a madness of terror and leap overboard. The victory is absolute, with all the enemy either drowned or fleeing south. The designs of Sauron are undone by these wraiths using his own weapons of fear and darkness against him. It is there and then that Aragorn deems their oath fulfilled. He tells the dead,
"Now hear the words of the heir of Isildur. Your oath is fulfilled. Go back, and trouble not the valleys ever again. Depart, and be at rest."
The king of the dead steps forward, breaks his spear, and casts it down. He then bows to Aragorn. He turns away, and the entire army of the dead men vanishes like a mist driven back by a sudden wind. At last, the men of the mountains leave Middle-earth and have their peace. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to leave a like and hit subscribe. Thanks as always to my Patreon patrons, including wizard-level supporter Tom DeBombadil19. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time on Nerd of the Rings.